Everything is easy when you are busy, but nothing is easy when you are lazy. Do you ever find yourself procrastinating, putting off tasks, and struggling to find the motivation to get things done? You're not alone. Laziness is a common challenge many of us face, but it doesn't have to hold us back. Today, I'll share 6 powerful Japanese techniques that can help you overcome laziness and boost your productivity. Number 1. Ikigai. Ikigai means purpose in life or reason for being. It's about finding what you love, what you're good at, what the world needs, and what you can be paid for. When you find your ikigai, you feel a sense of purpose and passion that gives meaning to your everyday life. Discovering your ikigai can help overcome laziness by giving you a clear sense of purpose and motivation. When you have a strong reason for getting out of bed each day, you're more likely to feel energized and motivated to take action. Your ikigai serves as a driving force, reminding you of what's important to you and inspiring you to overcome laziness and pursue your goals with enthusiasm and determination. Number 2. Kaizen. Kaizen means continuous improvement. It's about taking small steps every day, even if they're tiny. These small steps adds up over time and leads to substantial progress. For example, imagine you want to get fit and healthy. Instead of aiming for something big like running a marathon right away, you should start small. You could begin with a 10-minute walk every day and then gradually add other exercises like push-ups, squats, or jumping jacks. As you get used to these exercises, you gradually increase the time or intensity. Then start doing exercises for 15 minutes each day, then move to 20, and so on. Over time, these small changes will make a big difference in your fitness level without feeling overwhelmed. That's the power of Kaizen. It has been seen that companies that implement Kaizen often experience significant productivity improvements. For example, Toyota gained productivity of up to 120% within a few years of implementing Kaizen. Kaizen helps you to beat laziness by breaking big tasks into small, manageable steps. You feel less overwhelmed and more motivated to take action when you focus on small improvements each day. With Kaizen, you celebrate small wins, which keeps you motivated and builds momentum over time. By making continuous progress, you avoid feeling stuck or discouraged, and laziness becomes easier to overcome. Number 3. Mushin. Mushin means mind without mind or no mind. It's a state of mental clarity and awareness, where the mind is calm, free from distractions, preconceptions, doubts, and overthinking. In Mushin, you're fully present in the moment. You let go of conscious thought and allow your actions to flow naturally, which can lead to increased focus, efficiency, and creativity. Imagine you're playing a musical instrument, like the piano. In a state of Mushin, your mind is completely absorbed in the music. You're not thinking about which keys to press or worrying about making mistakes. Instead, you're flowing effortlessly from one note to the next, guided purely by your intuition and muscle memory. It's as if the music is playing through you, and you're simply a conduit for its expression. In this state, you experience a sense of deep concentration and joy, free from the distractions of self-doubt or analysis. Mushin can help overcome laziness by eliminating the mental barriers and excuses that often prevent us from taking action. When you're in a state of Mushin, you're fully engaged in the present moment, without dwelling on past failures or worrying about future obstacles. You are free from distractions and overthinking. This allows you to simply start whatever task you need to do without getting bogged down by doubts or procrastination. You act instinctively and with clarity, making it easier to overcome laziness and get things done. Mushin helps you bypass the mental resistance that laziness creates, enabling you to dive into tasks with a focused and proactive mindset. Number 4. Seiri, Seiton, and Seiso, often referred to as the 3S, are Japanese principles for organizing and maintaining cleanliness in the workplace. Here's what they mean. Seiri. It's about sorting through items in your workspace and getting rid of anything that is unnecessary or no longer needed. It's about decluttering and keeping only what is essential for your work. Seiton. Set in order. Arrange the remaining items in an organized and systematic manner. Everything should have a designated place, making it easy to find and access when needed. Seiso, shine. Seiso focuses on cleanliness and hygiene. It involves regularly cleaning and maintaining your workspace to ensure that it is neat and tidy. A clean environment not only improves morale, but also helps prevent accidents and promotes a sense of pride in your work. By following these principles, you can create a neat, organized, and efficient workspace, which can help improve productivity, overcome laziness, and stay focused on your tasks. Number 5. Wabi Sabi. Wabi Sabi is about finding beauty in imperfection and appreciating the simplicity of things. When you embrace wabi-sabi, you accept things as they are, including yourself, which can help you overcome the pressure of perfectionism and the fear of failure. Instead of waiting for conditions to be perfect before starting something, you can start where you are and appreciate the beauty of the journey, flaws and all. Imagine you have a favorite mug that you've had for years. It's chipped in a few places and the color is fading, but you still love it. Every time you use it, you're reminded of the memories and moments it has been a part of. That's wabi-sabi, finding beauty in the imperfections and appreciating the unique character of things, just as they are. This shift in perspective beats laziness by shifting your focus from perfection to appreciation. Accepting imperfections as part of life's beauty helps you overcome the fear of not doing things perfectly. By embracing imperfection, you're more likely to take action and move forward, making progress toward your goals. Remember the Japanese proverb, "Nothing lasts, nothing is finished, and nothing is perfect." We are humans, and we can never be perfect. So don't get caught up in the trap of perfectionism. Just start. Number 6, Gaman. Gaman is about patience, perseverance, endurance, and staying strong in the face of challenges and adversity. When you practice Gaman, you're able to persevere through difficult times without giving up. Instead of letting laziness or setbacks discourage you, Gaman helps you stay determined and focused on your goals, even when things get tough. Imagine you're working on a project that's taking longer than expected, and you encounter numerous obstacles along the way. Instead of becoming frustrated or giving up, you practice Gaman by maintaining patience and perseverance. Despite challenges, you stay focused and resilient, working diligently towards your project, and ultimately, you complete it. Gaman helps you focus on finding solutions rather than dwelling on problems, and remind yourself that difficulties are temporary, and every setback is an opportunity for growth and learning. By practicing Gaman, you develop inner strength and resilience, and it enables you to overcome laziness and face life's challenges with grace and determination. In conclusion, incorporating these Japanese techniques into your life can help you overcome laziness and boost your productivity. Whether it's through continuous improvement with Kaizen, finding your purpose with Ikigai, or cultivating mental clarity with Mushin, embracing imperfection with Wabi Sabi, or practicing patience and perseverance Gaman, there are many ways to overcome laziness and achieve your goals. Remember, progress is made one step at a time, so don't be discouraged if you don't see immediate results. Keep practicing these techniques, and you'll soon notice how your laziness would transform into productivity and success. Now, I'd love to hear from you. Which technique resonated most with you? Share your thoughts in the comments below.